want to set them in front of this?
No, right next to the bundles.
Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Tom Mende.
How you doing, sir?
August 24th, 2015. The guys are up here getting ready to do the next section of roof. It's pretty awesome.
Huh? Yeah. That's four bundles right here. Are they needing right now? Thank you. gonna sit on the ends of them. Hey, we need to get them some bundles
what?
Up there. We need to get them some bundles up there, bro. Bundles, they need bundles.
Thank you.
Geek Group. It is time for viewer mail, which we haven't gotten to do in a while, but now they're done with the roof, the floor is clean, the set is back together. We have toilet paper!
Yes!
It's from the Nietzsche! Thank you, sir! And we have paper towels that are also from the Nietzsche. Who loves you best? Thank you, Denichi.
It's so cute.
Mr. Bellatini, sir.
Oh. It's been so long, I forgot about it.
You forgot about the box?
I put this in there like 2 weeks ago.
It was adorable. The mail lady brought a bunch of stuff that day, and she pulled that out of her pocket and said, I can't forget this one.
It says dinosaur toy inside. Like I couldn't tell. By the way, this is from... there's no name. Someone in New York. Not enough tape. There's still some paper.
Only we had a note.
I don't trust me with sharp objects anymore.
Not since he is.
All it says is dinosaur toy inside. I think that's the entire note. Oh, no, it isn't.
Sparkles.
There's also a tiny note that says that your dinosaurs are your dinosaur. Zzz, are wrong. Okay, you squeezed the S and the R together there, human. I know nothing about who sent this or why, but it's what appears to be a Megalosaurus? Or maybe some kind of Raisukian?
You just made that up right now.
I did not make that up. Someone made that up, but it wasn't me. Thank you to whoever.
Raisukian. Those are the bad guys on Battlestar Galactica. This is for Moose, from Animals Rule.
It's from Cheese.
It is from Cheese. Animals Rules makes squeegees, apparently. But you've got, and it's got the little chiseler.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong with the little chiseler.
She saw us
doing... We have scanner audio over your audio. Because Ed has left the scanner on for like 3 days now. Yeah, I'm not surprised. We had scanner audio over my show last night. So, yeah.
She saw us applying vinyl and felt very bad for me.
She loves you. Hey, Brian.
Uh-huh.
Wrist straps.
Sweet.
In a festive blue.
Lovely.
They're from John McFerrin. Hello, I've sent 20 4 or 5 packs of anti-static wrist straps. I suggest splitting them up 10 to the computer lab, 10 to the electronics lab. By the way, the notes are the same. Just put the same thing on all of them. I'm sure you got it. Okay. For Chris B, personal.
Hello, my name's George.
Everybody got your rebreather?
It's a handwritten note.
It's not official enough.
Hey, Cap, you know when you're working behind a computer under a desk or in CCC in the dark, plug in a couple of these USB lights in somewhere to help with that. I find them useful for cabling. I don't know that one. Cabling something and whatever. They work equally as well on a USB battery or on a USB charger. I'll keep one in my pocket for situations like that. They can be plugged in either direction. Every little bit helps. Ken Wolf?
Ken Wolf.
Ken Wolf. I know.
These are really cool.
I'm genuinely excited about this.
There's USB ports right over there. You can demonstrate those with.
Where?
Right down there.
All right.
USB port.
There you go.
How about that?
Come put it.
Oh, wow, they're bright as hell. These are neat. And he says you can plug them in either direction, and you indeed can.
These are cool.
Okay, those, that's one of those things that I'm happy this exists. Didn't know that existed 5 minutes ago, and now my world is a slightly better place. Thank you, Ken, that's cool.
A slightly better place. In the darkness that is my world.
This is for Matt Thomas.
It's from Matt Thomas.
It says to Matt Thomas.
It lies.
Oh, it's for Matt's nipple clip collection. Okay. I forgot. We're almost to September now. It's a horrible feeling. You don't realize that that's sandpaper until you flip it over. It's a thing of sandpaper. From Lamination Depot.
Oh. Another whole bunch.
Maybe this one's not broken.
The other one's broken?
Yes.
Did it break before or after we punched 500 membership cards with it?
After.
Okay, so. Maybe you just ask a lot. Batman can put that together. So we have a package here. Okay, this one's for Moose. It's a present. Not viewer mail. I think it's Matt professing his love for you. And this one doesn't say who it's for. Tell us everything that is wrong right now. I think this is for Mr. Bellatini. You ordered it, you're supposed to know. Okay, Mr. Bellatini, come here.
I have very short memory.
Lots of drugs.
Heck, Moose can open that on viewer mail. See everything in there is viewer mail.
Disappearing dinosaur.
Oh, that's kind of cool. How
you have to share it.
Okay, so you pour liquid into the mug, and I'm not sure if the dinosaur disappears when you pour liquid in or if it appears when you pour liquid in, but it transfers between flesh and bone. And considering that the bones are postured incorrectly, I'm going to assume that the dinosaur.
Some warm liquid in it.
They had to posture it like that so they could fit it in the mug.
We got a sauropod living in a swamp, which is, you know, not unfeasible, but is also reflective of old ideas.
That's why they have the really long neck, so they can walk on the bottom because they can't swim.
That makes no sense.
They breathe air. Birds, not fish.
What's the,
It's called a tree.
There's a word for, like, how much air you have to move in order to breathe. And they have a lot of it in that neck.
See it?
But he's got his hands pronated down, which is not accurate for a Tyrannosaurus. He's got these absurdly short...
But the arms on the other dude.
Right here.
I don't know what that guy's trying to do. Like, that's not unreasonable for what we know about...
It's totally how
what
dinosaurs
I
look.
With its little dromaeosaur shoulder.
It's a gorilla sword.
Couldn't swallow him. Gangsta sword.
Thank you, Matt Thomas.
I have a very big box.
What's your base?
A through wall fan with switch.
That's not viewer mail, but cool.
It's in there. Where's it going?
Knock one.
Knock one.
Knock one.
Knock one! Ah!
It would be great if I could go to Mach 1. Just cost it.
I used to own a company called Mach 1. It was a recording studio. Get it?
Yes.
Okay, it's a fan in a box.
I'm a fan in a box. Yeah.
Okay. And that's, oh, this has been in there for you for a while.
Oh, gee, thanks.
You were gone that day or something. I don't know. It's Will's birthday, but he's not here. And Harvey, I'm out of multi-tools and flashlights, just so you know. All right, that's viewer mail for the day. You guys have fun. We'll be back after this.
Yeah.
1641 hours and Batman's gonna change the blade in the bandsaw.
Slowly but surely. Okay.
The
it's a little stuck.
There we rail go. Kinda cheesed the other one.
Oh. Yeah, but we cut a lot of pieces of rail. So what do you do with the blades when they're junk?
I just scrap them.
Yeah?
Some of them are neat to keep for other things, but most of them don't scrap.
Now, will that blade fit that no. saw? Is too long or too short?
It's gonna be way, that's a three-wheel setup.
It's too wide, actually.
Okay.
Actually, it might fit, because that takes up to 1 inch. Is this 1 inch?
No, it's 1.25 inches.
I haven't had a chance to read all the plates on that one yet.
But the other thing about this is the toothpick on the inverse.
Yeah, this is also way too aggressive. For
that.
Oh man, if this would fit in the no, Grizzly, this would cut wood great.
They're 1 inch, please.
Oh, they're only 1 inch? Yeah, then. I don't know. Try it.
Let me see that blade.
Stand right next to the guy. Holding the
give me that blade. I have an awesome ringtone to get here.
Oh.
Everybody be quiet a second. Somebody needs to send me that as an MP3 file. There's a ringtone nobody has. If it lands teeth side down, that's bad for it. This is the coolest sound ever, man. Yep. That's my new message sound.
I think that you should add a bit of excitement to hula hooping.
Yeah.
Good, great.
There's like all kinds of really awesome physics going on here. Here, I'm handing this off to you.
Okay. I kind of want to find a way to mount this for my drum set.
Gonna freak out.
You could.
Play with one bandsaw. It actually works.
Hey, Casey?
Mm-hmm.
How hard would it be for you to drill me a hole exactly opposite? Two holes? Okay.
Yeah.
Like, perfectly in line. At about, let's say, I don't know, it's a 1-inch blade, 3/8 hole, maybe a half through that. I know this stuff's tough as nails. Can you drill a hole through it?
I don't even know if I can.
I want you to try, because I got an idea.
I know how you can get it exactly, or bring it right together.
Yeah.
No, it can't be creased. It's got to be...
No, you
but they got to be, can, they got to be like...
You can bring this together, touch it without creasing, drill your hole, and it'll be perfectly across from each other at that point.
But you got to measure out for the hole here, here, here. It's got to be... Each loop has to be the same.
Yeah.
Like, really, really close to the same. Which you could do with a soft, like a cloth tape measure.
Yeah.
All the way around. Yeah. All right, you have a project. I need two holes. Because I can do something really cool with it. The first step is, I need two holes. The second step is sliders. It's going to be neat. You'll see.
What white cats
do? Huh?
What do white cats
do? No. Do you play guitar?
Yes.
Okay. You ever seen a spring reverb?
Yes. Oh, sure.
Yeah. We're going to make a spring reverb.
That'd be neat.
So back to Batman. Hey, Batman. That's the brush for the parts cleaner.
No, it's not.
It looks like the brush for the parts cleaner.
It looks like one, but you notice there's no hose really going through it.
He can drill a hole. I've got him drilling holes for me.
It doesn't matter, because I don't
it's
have
a
parts
hole driller.
Anyway. It works really well for getting metal crud out of stuff. It's a parts cleaner brush or something. that has nothing to do.
Oh, the guy you were talking about with the wood lathe thing? Is that what you were asking about? He had the part that needed to be modified for his wood lathe.
I don't know nothing about it. I just know Matt was on the radio all through lunch looking for you.
Yeah, well...
I know! Matt has difficulty understanding that at lunchtime, everybody vanishes.
I'm sorry that you can't just tell the members, sorry, come back later.
I normally try to stagger with lunch, but Batman wanted to go to lunch, so that's what we did. But anyway,
seems like a job would be way better with a shot pack.
Nah, it's all sticky. It clogs up the hose.
Need a bigger shot pack.
That's 2 inch. It's pretty big. It's the ridges, really. See, I had seen this floating around the machine shop, this blue sheet. I was like, what the hell is this from?
Yeah. Dog! Hi, dog.
That's a hell of a blade.
What?
Good thing it requires two.
Now, how do you know when it's tight enough?
When it's tight enough.
Okay.
Without grabbing the tool.
Okay.
This thing needs...
Because the pitch on that screw is too high. Or, I never know how to say that, low or high. The pitch is too low. Nope. Yeah.
Low would be a small number of threads.
Well, the pitch number would be higher.
Oh, okay. Holes. Yeah, okay.
But the number of threads...
Is good?
Well, the blade's in now, but now I gotta square it. It's been cutting crooked lately.
How do you square it?
Not what I need.
You get a machinist square. clamp it in there, and then you adjust. There's these bolts slide, and there's a set of bolts here that slide, and you adjust them until they're straight, 90 with your clamp.
These two bolts adjust this back and forth.
And these two bolts adjust this one. Okay. So whatever one's
and
out of whack.
It can also rotate just a little bit in either direction.
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
That's the next one. Also, internet. I need a new piston for this thing. And I'm having shit luck finding one.
It is a Ramco RS100P.
That's the number they want. I need a new piston. It's oozing still.
Did
we
you
know it's
call
the
there
oozing.
And see what a piston costs?
It
says a phone number.
Yeah, there's a phone number.
Right on
the
phone thing.
Number didn't have anything.
You can say, I have this model, and this serial number, I need that, and they'll say, $30.
They exist still, yes.
Ramco doesn't exist anymore?
Oh, that phone number doesn't anymore.
Oh, okay.
Nobody answers it.
Okay. You know, you could go to Grand Rapids Industrial Surplus and sort that out pretty easy, because that's a very generic little piston.
I think that.
It's like a 1-inch piston lifted all the way up. Okay, so if you had a 1-inch piston with, like, 8-10 inches of stroke, you got plenty. I mean, that's a chintzy, low-end, craptastic piston. You could do that out of a nice...
Well, I like something that isn't quite crap.
Yeah, but you could have a nice Bimbo air cylinder there to do the exact same thing and be awesome.
It's supposed to be adjustable. That's why it's hydraulic. It's supposed to be adjustable.
You can use an air piston with a hydraulic...
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Oh, I was thinking the air spring like you use for...
Oh, my God.
Closer.
Yeah, as it'll be okay.
Whatever, they'll have it by
It'll be okay.
That
you're not supposed to do that.
If the thing actually works right,
you're totally not supposed to have a coffee can half full of nails that sits on the
that's,
end
that's
of the bandsaw.
That's why this is sitting at a weird.
We're just
going to
put a decent sized magnet on there. Because
my dad had
a
coffee
bit,
can half full of nails.
Needs a little bit more pressure than what it
just
gets.
Put
from
a lead
weight
in the back there. I'm sure I got some lead weight floating around somewhere.
So does it work?
Hmm.
Does it work?
I'm gonna go get my wrench and stuff. You keep bugging me.
Pump don't work. It's broken. I'm just gonna pet the dog. I'm just gonna pet the dog.
Hi, dog. Hi, dog.
Yes, you should lick her. You should get your tongue all the way up her nose or lick her eye.
No.
Girls like that when you lick their eye.
So
it's a huge turn on.
And licked Minkus. And he said, don't do that. You know what happened last time. I just looked at him and went, what happened last time? And he said, I licked your back.
Ew.
That explains why the dog's traumatized.
Ew.
Yeah. Because if it pulls out on you, then it's going to pull out on somebody else. And that's bad, because then it'll start arcing weird. And if it starts arcing, it starts melting the plug. You start popping breakers, you're blowing fuses. You make shit mad. You want to make sure you don't have any loose fray wires, so nothing's sticking out above, nothing's going to touch.
These are really nice plugs, too.
Yes, they are.
We've had to do this in way jankier ones. These have, like, the little cups and guards and stuff.
Yeah, these are the only ones I buy now. Because these are, like... Because you got the $5 ones, which you do not want to buy a $5 20-amp 480 plug. Then you have, like... the $20 ones, and then you can buy them for like $60. You don't need the $60 ones. We get the
$60 ones. You don't have to strip or anything. You just take the cord and stick it in the end, and you press a little button. And there's little strippers and everything. It just connects it all and gets all your phasing right on the first try. Like it never spins a motor backwards. They're pretty cool. That's why they cost so much.
I wish that was that. And this is keyed, so when you put these two pieces together, it only goes together one way.
I kind of want to go and buy like a $5 one, a $30 one, and an $80 one, and just do a blog video on the comparison. Like, splice each one in and show people how they work and how they're done.
And these are also keyed, so they slide in just like that.
It's very sexy. Now you got to have the right key on the inside, the insert, the black part there. They're different. Like, when you open the box, these will be different for different size cable.
Oh, yeah.
And they're reversible.
Yeah, that's the biggest size. That's the bigger size.
Okay.
What you want for this guy? This is a pretty beefy frickin' cable. And you want to make sure you're biting onto black and not onto these. Because that's the nice, thick, heavy part. Thick and heavy.
And if you're doing a 480 setup, you got to make sure your cable's rated to 600 volts. Because there's a lot of things in the electrical world that are rated to 300 volts. It's a different insulation class. You can't use those on 480 stuff. So you got to make sure you have 600 volts.
So everything's nice together. That's not coming out. We're good.
Now you gotta terminate it and saw it.
I don't need quite as much. Yeah, we'll leave it for now. I'll clean it up later. This is just to see if this stupid thing won't happen. It's usually a very good idea just to start, if you're using wire that's been used for something before, just start all new ends. Makes life way easier.
Those flat. Wire's heavier than their wire. Take out these other pigtails.
I'll see. I need a flat blade screwdriver that's narrower. Next time I have one.
Thank you, Harvey, for the awesome tool bag.
Oh, I've already thanked him. It's okay. Dick for it. So. Yeah, you're too slow. Unless I found one in the tool bag.
Tool bag's so big.
I want to see a proper strain relief in there, too.
Yeah. God, yes. But for now, we're just seeing if this stupid thing will work. Because we got to see if it'll actually work before Batman spends hours on end getting stuff to move. See if it's worth replacing belts and parts and buying the blade for it, etc., etc.
What's up, girl?
Leaving before I close.
Oh, okay.
It's that kind of day.
Yes.
Monday.
You want to tell the world the source of your stress?
Donation receipts that didn't actually
it's all
do
my
what
fault.
They were supposed to do.
Oh.
Got through like 30 lines. You know, push submit, started another one, 30 lines, push submit, refresh the page, they weren't even there. It's for the TV station, so everything.
Oh, God, and it's got to be perfect, yeah.
It's... I'm gonna go have some whiskey.
That's a good plan. Have fun.
I know that headache. I've had that a couple times when I was doing the donation receipts. Just every now and then. I'd freak out and I'd lose everything. And it's always on the big ones. Like, you can't handle the amount of items or something.
Smoke test! 1804 hours.
Okay. I'll look at the welder. Are you working
on it? There's nothing in it.
Right, but I didn't know if the...
There's nothing in it.
Well, that's freaking...
Turn the breaker... Turn the grinder on. I don't think you got voltage. Is it turned off? It's turned off. It's turned off. Pull things off. Get out! Get
power.
Back! Go! That's cool as hell.
I don't care which direction that spins, but...
Woo. Goes the right way. Wow, that's set for fast.
Motor works.
Cool.
We needed to check. Surprise and quiet. In the red drawers, in the tool room, bottom of the drawers is a brown bag. Relatively brown bag. Grab that brown bag. Khaki brown bag.
So Ed! A couple days ago, like last week, I told you on the, you know, a couple of the live speakers for the guys on the roof. Remember?
No.
Yes. The angly ones.
You told me you wanted me to put some of those in the computer lab.
No, on the roof too. Get with Joe.
Hi.
Get a pair of those speakers. Get them set up so we can deploy them on the roof easily. They'll need the two speakers, a couple long lengths of speaker cable, an amplifier, and a radio receiver. Just LAB is all we need. We don't need anything special. All right? But I would like this to happen presently so that when you guys get here at 7 a.m., we can just roll out speakers and they got speakers. All right?
Those are meant to, if you're welding, you can
cool.
put the welder.
Happy workers.
Park. Let's do that.
Okay. So you're going to play with the welder?
I'm going to play with the welder.
This totally doesn't end in tears.
Does it cut too?
Yeah, it cuts. That's what this does.
Yeah,
this cuts. But you gotta line it up to cut. Have you ever used one of these before, Batman?
Nope.
Hey, Batman.
Yeah.
It doesn't cut so much as. Stop. You need to close this gap. It's too big.
I don't know how you close it.
I don't know either, but I know that gap is too big.
That's right. I just need the blade to not be. One together anymore. There we go.
Hey, Batman.
Yeah.
Blade's broken.
Yep.
Hey, Batman.
Yep.
You gotta cut it and not have the bent off ends there.
You're gonna
have a big kink in your blade.
I don't care.
It's a bad blade. Well, now, but you can make it better. If you had a welder, a cutter, and a grinder, you can make the blade way better.
I don't want to make it. It's all done. It's worn to shit. I don't care.
Okay.
I just want to see if this thing will actually...
Have you ever used anything even remotely like this before?
It's a welder.
Okay.
Don't look at it.
Ooh.
Did it weld?
That was not what I was expecting. Yeah, it started to. I didn't have it there long enough.
So I got a touch.
I was expecting a... This is an older style.
It's a resistance welder.
Yeah. The newer ones are... And it's done. This one. That's rather terrifying.
That's cool.
That's neat.
That is rather neat.
Oh, that's supposed to move with it. Hey, it's not quite working right. Yeah.
Welded together then.
Yeah.
Hang on, how did you move that? You moved the lever and the thing down here.
Yeah, that's... Oh. It's, you're supposed to bring it together and...
Okay.
That's not...
That's why it's labeled in millimeters. That's a millimeter apart, 2 millimeters apart, 3 millimeters. Like that. I like the smell.
Yeah. It's a neat thing, and you can play with it, but I'm not going to leave it on this.
Okay.
That's a fire starter. Wait,
the welder?
Yeah, totally.
The welder stays. Welder stays.
No one's ever going to use it.
I'm okay with nobody ever using it, but it stays. It's cool. I'm gonna restore it. No, it stays. Functional, usable. I may have an application for it at some point.
Then you can put it on the application.
No, it stays. I like the welder. It's part of the saw. We're going to restore the saw to its original beauty.
Kalamazoo saws is still a thing.
Yeah.
They still make
They're still in business.
Their newer ones are much... They haven't changed too much.
The company is composed of dicks, but they're still in business. Yeah. They used to be like a quarter mile up the street from the lab. They were the closest company we ever tried to get as a sponsor, and they just told us to piss off.
Oh, you're only supposed to run it at 3,600 RPM.
That's I think that's higher than that.
Yeah, I think so. So, it wants a new belt. Definitely needs a new belt.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
I know you want to restore it to its original glory, but I think we have to...
We're going to put a new switch. We'll put one of the nice... We got the boxes from...
the start-stop.
Scalen.
Scalen, yeah.
Yeah, we'll put a Scalen box in there.
Start-stop. Yeah, because then I could affix an e-stop there.
Yeah.
Alright. So it needs a lot of other love, because I gotta figure out what's up with this wheel. When you tighten its thing, it's a little wibbly out of here.
That's because when you tighten this here, you're moving the wheel out from the thing.
No.
This, yes.
When you loosen that, it starts to pivot the wheel so you can adjust its tracking. You can't leave it loose or else it'll just start messing with its tracking.
Okay, I'm gonna put a camera right here. And the tracking is weird on the wheel. It
wobbles. When you tighten it, goes like that.
When you tighten it, it comes out.
One half of the wheel goes out.
It's an alignment thing.
Something's wrong with it. It should just. Yeah, there's something weird with this setup.
Okay.
I got to figure out what. Because it should be the way it seems. Should be. Tighten it down and it stays where you want it.
Okay. You just figure that out. Let me know.
It's something I gotta play with.
Okay, I believe in you.
I can't find any manuals online. Well, you can buy them for $50.
Hey, IRC, find us a manual for this, please.
The 18V10.
It's gotta look like that.
Well, a lot of the bandsaws look like
this. Yeah.
It's this number here that's important. I said like the 14V and the 20V, and that's just the throat size.
All right, gentlemen, it's 21:37 hours, and we have a few people to thank before I do the edit.
I want to thank Robert W., who just pledged $2. Tom Mende is the day sponsor. He edited his pledge up to $25. Joseph Bargabos is in for $1. Thank you, sir. Scott Trudeau is in for $1. Thank you, sir. All right. Dean... He upped it to get me to pronounce his name again. I'm going to say it's Dean Riordan, but... because that's what it looks like. I'm going to go with Dean Riordan. I could be wrong on that, but I'm saying it's Dean Riordan. He's up to $250. Thank you, sir. Josh Manalo is in for $1. You rock. Tom Mende started out as 10. He came in early at 10. He's like, hey, I could be a day sponsor at 25. So that's awesome. Thank you. I need more day sponsors. I'm out now. I just did Tom. I got no more day sponsors. You could be a day sponsor. It's $25 a month. That's it. And, you know, I'll make you famous. Me and Billy the Kid. You guys have fun. That's today's Captain's Blog. Thank you, everyone who helped out on Patreon. And I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Good night. Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Tom Mende.